Good afternoon, students. How are you? Hope you are fine. And what about your lunch? Had your lunch? So up to last class, you were learning about dual nature of radiation and matter. In dual nature of radiation and matter, you learned electron emission, types of electron emission. And in those types of electron emission, you briefly learned about, you learned in detail about photoelectric effect. What is photoelectric effect? And what is the experimental study of photoelectric effect? And what is the explanation of photoelectric effect? Experimental results of photoelectric effect. And you learned experimental results in two ways. One is based on the experimental study of photoelectric effect, what are the results, and another one is results of photoelectric effect based on Einstein's equation. So, and you learned about photons, what are photons, and what are the characteristics of photons, and lastly you learned about de Broglie waves. What are de Broglie waves? Formula for de Broglie wave of a particle and formula for de Broglie wave of an electron. So that completes your dual nature of matter and radiation. So for this year, the concept of Davison and Germer experiment is removed from the syllabus. Due to this COVID-19, that concept was removed. So I am not discussing about that one, Davison and Germer experiment. So I am directly going to start the next chapter, that is atoms. Atoms, from which you are getting about 5 marks for your final examination. 5 marks for your final examination. So here, in this chapter, you are learning about atoms. What are atoms, and what are the constituents of an atom, and what is the structure of an atom, how the electrons are arranged, and here to understand about atoms, you are learning different models: Bohr's atom model, Rutherford's atom model, Thomson's atom model. So you are learning 3 atom models in this chapter. And see, to understand about atom, you are also learning one about alpha scattering experiment, Rutherford's alpha scattering experiment. And see here, in this chapter, structure of hydrogen atom is explained, and all the models, they say only about hydrogen atom, only about hydrogen atom, not any helium or oxygen atom. So here the complete chapter is discussed about hydrogen atom, structure of hydrogen atom. So first of all, what is an atom? As you know that atom is a smallest particle of an element. Here atom is the smallest particle of an element. So if we take a sample, in that sample you can imagine many number of atoms. So atoms are the smallest particles of an element. So if this is the atom here, if this is an atom, an atom is having a central part called the nucleus. N represents nucleus, and here nucleus is the central part of an atom, and around the nucleus there are circular orbits are found. These are the orbits. Around the nucleus, many orbits are found, and in these orbits, there are electrons are revolving. Here, E means electrons. E is electrons. See, sometimes E is also called as a charge of an electron. E is also used for a charge of an electron. And in the nucleus, inside the nucleus, there are protons and neutrons. Protons protons and neutrons. See, these protons are positively charged particles. Protons means positively charged particles, and neutrons means negatively charged particles. Protons are positively charged particles, and neutrons are negatively charged particles. Neutrons are the particles which are electrically neutral. They are not having any charge. Electrically neutral. So what it means? They are not having any particular charge. They are neither positively charged nor negatively charged. They are having no charge. So here neutrons are not having any charge. So they are referred as electrically neutral. So protons are positively charged particles. Electrons are negatively charged particles. Negatively charged particles. Right? So see, what I'm telling is atom is one of the smallest part of an element. Carbon element, hydrogen element, oxygen element. Moola vastuvina atyanta sanna ondu bhagavanna naavu enu karita idivi, atom antu karita idivi. See here, atom is consisting of two parts. One is nuclear part, that is nucleus. Here this part is called nucleus. Around the nucleus we are having extra nuclear part. That extra nuclear part, in extra nuclear part, electrons are found revolving around the nucleus. And atom is said to be electrically neutral. Atom is electrically neutral. What it means? Atom is neither having positive charge nor having negative charge. Atom is considered to be having zero charge. Its charge is zero. It is not either positively charged body or negatively charged body. Atom is an electrically neutral. Atom is electrically neutral. So see, when you call electrically neutral, and we are saying that inside the atom there is a nucleus, and inside the nucleus olagade protons and neutrons olagade nucleus olagade protons plus neutrons. Nucleus is the central part of an atom. An atom is the smallest part of an element, right? Is it clear to you? Here nucleus is present in the central part of an atom. And inside the nucleus, neutrons and protons are present. Inside the nucleus, what are present? Neutrons and protons. Outside the nucleus, what are present? Electrons are present. And see, you know that electrons are negatively charged particles, protons are positively charged particles, and neutrons are electrically neutral. So it means here, what is the charge of nucleus? Charge of nucleus is always positively charged. Because inside the nucleus you are having protons and neutrons. Nucleus olagade enide proton matu neutron ide. Proton matu neutron ide. Adralli proton galige yav charge ide? Positive charge ide. Neutron ge electrically neutral charge illa. So complete nucleus na charge enu helbodu naavu? Positive charge ide. Nucleus is said to be positively charged, right? And electrons are negatively charged particles. See, electrons are found around the nucleus. So its meaning is both negative and positive charge are present inside the atom. So in an atom there is a nucleus, and around the nucleus there are found electrons revolving. So here positive charge is present in the nucleus, negative charge is present outside. outside of the nucleus. So how the atom is, now you tell me how it is electrically neutral. How means both the positive charge and the negative charge, they are equal in magnitude. How much positive charge is present inside the nucleus, that much of negative charge is present outside the nucleus. So here the total number of protons is always equals to number of protons. Proton number is always equals to, it is always equals to electron number. Proton number is always equals to electron number in an atom. So this is why we can say atom is electrically neutral, because all the positive charge is cancelled, neutralized by the negative charge, right? All the positive charge of an atom is neutralized or cancelled by the negative charge of the electrons. Here positive charge is due to protons and negative charge is due to electrons. So in an atom, if 5 protons are present, means 5 electrons are present around the nucleus. In the nucleus, 5 protons are present means 5 electrons are present outside the nucleus. So the number of protons is always taken equal to number of electrons in an atom. So what is an atom? It is the smallest particle of an element. Atom, what is the charge of an atom? Its charge is 0. Zero charge, so electrically neutral. And what is there inside the atom? Inside the atom, nucleus is present. And what are there inside the nucleus? Protons and neutrons. Inside the nucleus, there are protons and neutrons. What is the charge of a proton? Positively charged. What is the charge of a neutron? Electrically neutral. What is the charge of an electron? Negatively charged. Electron means negatively charged. Proton means positively charged, neutron means electrically neutral, and whole atom charge is zero, electrically neutral. Because how many positively charged particles are present inside the nucleus? The same number of negatively charged particles are present outside the nucleus. This is why we call atom as an electrically neutral body. Electrically neutral body. See here, next one. In the year of 1897, a scientist named J.J. Thomson. J.J. Thomson, in the year of 1897, first of all, here, 1898, first thing, many scientists, they performed experiments to describe the structure of electrons and the structure of protons inside of an atom, how the electrons are present. Someone said atoms are electrically neutral. So then scientists, they started to think how much negative charge is present in an atom, whether that negative charge is same for all the atoms or different for all the atoms. So some scientists, they performed experiments and said that all the atoms, they are having negatively charged particles. So if negatively charged particles are present, means definitely an equal amount of positive charge is present in the atom. So next comes J.J. Thomson, as I wrote here earlier, in the year of 1898, a famous scientist, J.J. Thomson, he explained first model. Say yes, what is the first model of atom? Means J.J. Thomson model. And then he said said that in an atom, if this is an atom, imagine this is an atom, this is the atom. In an atom, negative charges are uniformly distributed throughout the volume of the atom. Negative charges are uniformly distributed throughout the atom. Negative charges are uniformly distributed. Wait, but good. See here. So I was discussing about J.J. Thomson model. So in J.J. Thomson model, what is said? All the positive charges, not negative charges, all the positive charges of an atom, all the positive charges of an atom, they are arranged uniformly in the same manner throughout the atom, throughout the surface of the atom. They are arranged, positive charges are arranged, are distributed in the same manner throughout of an atom. So positive charge is uniformly distributed throughout the volume of an atom, and negative charges are placed in between the positive charges, just like plums in a pudding, or seeds in an watermelon surface. Negative charges are placed just like the, here see, negative charges are like plums in pudding or seeds in on the surface of watermelon. So kallandi mele beeja hengirthava athava ee ondu yavdu idu cake irthada cake mele ni plums anta vena cherry and red color idu kodtharallo sweet item. So avengirthava athara electron arrangement agirutte ant helidirthu yavdu J.J. Thomson. First of all, J.J. Thomson was the first scientist to say about the structure of an atom, and he only said negatively charged particles and positively charged particles are present inside the atom. Cruy is one of the experiment, and he suggested one atom model, first atom model. Name the first atom model. J.J. Thomson's atom model. It was the first model to say about the structure of an atom. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನ್ ಆಟಮ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅರ್ಥ ಏನು ಗೊತ್ತಾ, ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಗಳು ಯಾವ ಥರ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್ಗಳು ಯಾವ ಥರ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅನ್ನೋದೇ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನ್ ಆಟಮ್. ಸೊ ಇಯರ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಜೆ ಜೆ ಥಾಮ್ಸನ್ ಮಾಡೆಲ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಡ್ ದಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಿ ಯೂನಿಫಾರ್ಮ್ಲಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಒಂದೇ ತರ ಈಕ್ವಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಥ್ರೂಔಟ್ ದ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆಟಮ್. ಅಂಡ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎಂಬೆಡೆಡ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಡೋದು. ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎಂಬೆಡೆಡ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಪ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಇನ್ ಪಡ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಸೀಡ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್ ಮೆಲನ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್, ಆನ್ ದ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಮೆಲನ್. ಬಟ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಸ್ ಪ್ರೂವ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಪ್ಪ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್, ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್ಸ್. The arrangement of protons and electrons are very much different as explained by J.J. Thomson model. They are very much different compared to the explanation given by J.J. Thomson model. So therefore, this model was rejected. It was rejected. ಇದನ್ನ ಅಪ್ರೂವಲ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಅಕ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಲ್ಲ. ಇವರು ಹೇಳಿ ಈ ಥರ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು, ಬಟ್ ಆ ಥರ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಗಳು ಹಂಗಿರಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಬೇರೆ ಸ್ಟಡೀಸ್ ಹೇಳಿತ್ತು. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಅನ್ ಆಟಮ್ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೋಟಾನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅನ್ ಆಟಮ್. ಸಾಲಿಡ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡಾಗ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ದೀಸ್ ಸಾಲಿಡ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಎಮಿಟ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ಸ್ ದೇ at all temperatures. I mean when they are heated to a temperature. So solids and liquids. Yes, what are solids and liquids? These are the forms of matter. Example for liquids, water, ether. So it is found that solids and liquids, they are emitting type of electromagnetic radiations are ultraviolet light, visible light, infrared rays, x-rays, gamma rays, microwaves, ether. These electromagnetic radiations, they are emitted from the solids and liquids when they are heated to a temperature. And these electromagnetic radiations, they are consisting of several different wavelengths. They are made up of different wavelengths. They are made up of different wavelengths. And it is suggested that the emission of electromagnetic radiations from the solids and liquids, it is possible due to the collision taking place between atoms and atoms, or molecules and molecules of an atom. Of a sample, inside the sample, solids are consisting of many number of atoms. A solid may have Avogadro number of atoms, and a liquid may consisting of many atoms. So when the question of here emission of electromagnetic radiations are X-ray, gamma ray, ultraviolet ray, visible light, infrared ray, yes, microwaves, these are electromagnetic radiations. So they are consisting of different wavelengths, and the emission of electromagnetic radiations, it is due to collision between atoms, different atoms of a solid, and atoms and molecules, different molecules of a solid. Molecule collision aage ad emission aagutte, athava atom collision aage emission aagutte. But gases enadru think madu, gases, this is the another form of matter. They are emitting gases nalli mercury vapor lamp, neon light, mercury vapor light. So they comes under gases consideration. So here mercury vapor lamp and neon light, they also emit electromagnetic, such as mercury vapor lamp and neon light. They are also giving out electromagnetic radiations. But here electromagnetic radiations of different wavelength, but here the emission of electromagnetic radiations in case of mercury and neon light, it is explained, it is due to collisions taking place between atoms and molecules, rather than it is due to spacing between the atoms of the gases. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಗಳು ಬಹಳ ದೂರ ದೂರಕ್ಕೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಈ ತರ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ, ನಾನು ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಕಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸಸ್, ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಎಮಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ಸ್, ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸಿಂಗ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಕೊಲಿಸನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಆಟಮ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಈ ತರ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್, ಇದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು, ಒಬ್ರು ಈ ತರ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು, ಒಬ್ರು ಈ ತರ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರು. ಸೊ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ವಾಸ್ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಎ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನ್ ಆಟಮ್, ಆರ್ ಎ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್, ಆರ್ ಎ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಮಾಡೆಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನ್ ಆಟಮ್. ದೆನ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನ್ ಆಟಮ್, ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಬೈ ರುದರ್ಫರ್ಡ್ Rutherford experiment. So Rutherford experiment of alpha particle scattering. So here Rutherford's experiment of alpha particle scattering, it was one of the well-known experiment which makes you to understand clearly about structure of an atom. What is an atom and where is the nucleus inside the atom? And what is the size of an atom? What is the size of a nucleus? And where does the positive charge is present inside the nucleus? And how the how the nucleus is different from the size of an atom? And where are the electrons? Where about what distance they are present from the nucleus? All the ideas are very clearly explained by Rutherford's alpha scattering experiment. Let me tell about Rutherford's alpha scattering experiment. Rutherford, he was one of the student of J.J. Thomson. Rutherford's, he conducted an experiment, Rutherford's alpha scattering. See here, this experiment was mainly explained by Rutherford, but the two students of the Rutherford, they conducted this experiment. The name of those two students are Hans Giger and Ernst Marsden. So they are H. Giger. H. Giger. E. Marsden. See the theory part of the alpha scattering experiment, it was explained by the Rutherford in the year of 1906. But later, after 5 years, in the year of 1911, the experiment was proved. The experiment was conducted by the two students of Rutherford, Hans Giger and Ernst Marsden, in the year of 1911. So, in this experiment, see, they used a lead cavity. This is the lead cavity. Now, we shall discuss the experimental study of alpha scattering experiment. This instrument is lead cavity. So here they place a source of alpha particle. What it is? Source of alpha particle. Bismuth. They use bismuth. Source of alpha particles. Here, see, I hope you know about alpha particle. Alpha particle is a helium nucleus. See, helium nucleus is called as alpha particle. Helium nucleus. This is called alpha particle. Alpha particle means positively charged particles, and they are similar to helium nucleus. Here, how many protons are? See, above number is called. This number is called. Is anybody what it is called? Mass number. Mass number. This number is called mass number, and this mass number represents total number of protons present in an atom. Mass number is how many protons are there in an atom, that was explained by mass number. So here 4 is called mass number, and mass number A, capital A, mass number A, and this 2 is called atomic number. 2 is called atomic number. How many electrons are there in an atom? It explained by atomic number. So the total number of here actually see atomic number. Now here 4 protons are there. 2 is the number of electrons or protons. number of electrons are called atomic number. Atomic number is z equals to total number of protons or electrons. Total number of protons or electrons. This is atomic number, right? So A is mass number. Mass number means it is protons plus neutrons. Total number of protons and neutrons present in atom, that is explained by its mass number. So here two protons, two neutrons, two electrons. Mass number 4 be and mass number and mass of proton and neutron, they are approximately similar. So now we are helium. For helium, alpha particle and helium nucleus. For helium, 4b, 2e, 4b. The mass of the bandaga. Mass of helium nucleus is 4b, and charge of helium nucleus is 2e, two times the electrons. Remember, here alpha particle is helium nucleus. So helium nucleus, the atomic number is 2. Mass number is 4. That is 4 protons, 2 electrons. Here one 2 electrons charge is there. 4 protons mass is there. Sir, only proton neutron is there. Proton and neutron, they are approximately, their mass is approximately similar to one another. Their mass is not different here. The mass of proton is equal to mass of neutron. So therefore, here the mass number is taken as 4p. 4 protons mass is there in helium. And 2 electrons charge is present in helium. Right? So next term, see here. This is lead cavity, and this is the source of alpha particle, bismuth. They used bismuth for this experiment. And what is the specialty of lead cavity? It allows only alpha particles to move out from the source. So a source, bismuth is a special for alpha radiation. A alpha radiation source it is, but it can emit beta and gamma radiations. Alpha, beta, gamma radiations. So in the bismuth source one then emit madala beta. So alpha na jaasti emit madidre beta na swalpa adre emit madabodu. Aa tara emission enadru aayitu antu tilkondre beta mattu gamma avugalanna absorb maadkolluvanta capacity lead cavity ide. It absorbs all the beta and gamma radiations, and it allows only alpha radiations to move out. So these are the alpha radiations. Many number of alpha particles are emitted from the source of alpha particle, and now they are moving out. So there they used a pair of lead bricks. Lead bricks, right? So here lead bricks. See what is the function of these two lead bricks? They are collimating. They are arranging group of alpha radiations into a narrow beam, a single beam. So here if 1000 number of alpha particles are emitted from the source beams, now it is arranged as a beam of alpha particles, a single beam, group of alpha particles. Now they are arranged as a single ray of alpha particles and move out of the lead bricks, and they used another device called gold foil. This is the gold foil, a gold colored metal plate. So this is gold foil. They used gold foil, and now these alpha, a narrow beam of alpha radiations, this is made to incident on the gold foil. So after hitting the atoms of the gold foil. Now these alpha radiations, they start scattering in different directions. I will tell why they are scattering in different directions. And they use the zinc sulfide screen, ZnS3. Zinc sulfide screen. So, and there is a detector, a microscope. Detector is a microscope. Detector is a microscope. So, see here, when they are incident, when this narrow beam of alpha particles, what it is? Beam of alpha particles.
I was searching for the chalk piece.
Beam of alpha particles. After hitting the gold foil, some alpha particles, they are scattering like this. Some are scattering like this. See here, alpha particles, these arrow marks are representing alpha particles. Alpha particles, after hitting the gold foil surface, they are scattered in different directions with different angles. That angle with what they are scattered out of the gold foil, that is angle of scattering. So see here, angle of scattering is almost zero because they are scattered in direct way, in single direction. So, and see, they produce a scintillation, a flash of light on the screen. A flash of light is scattered alpha particles. What are these? Scattered alpha particles. These are scattered alpha particles. And angle of scattering, angle of scattering is shown by their directions. This detector is a microscope. It is used for observing the light flashes of these radiations. It is movable one. It can be rotated throughout the screen. Even the microscope na ella kada rotate maadabodu. ಇದರಿಂದ ಏನಿತ್ತು ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ಲೈಟ್ ಫ್ಲಾಶಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಿಂಟಿಲೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೆದ್ರು ಇವುಗಳು ಏನಿವು ಸಿಂಟಿಲೇಷನ್ಸ್
ಅಥವಾ ಲೈಟ್ ಫ್ಲಾಶಸ್.
ಸಿಂಟಿಲೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಫ್ಲಾಶಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಲ್ಫಾ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್. So, by using this microscope, they are able to see the identify the flashes. Flashes are the direction of the scattering of alpha particles after hitting the gold foil. So, this is the diagram of this Rutherford's alpha scattering experiment. So, in the experimental study of Rutherford's alpha scattering experiment, it is consisting of a lead cavity and a source of alpha particles. Here the source used is bismuth. And they used a pair of lead bricks. So, and these pair of lead bricks, they collimated alpha radiations into a narrow beam, into a single beam. So, this narrow beam of alpha radiations, after passing out of the lead bricks, it is made to incident on a thin gold foil. And see, when this beam hits the gold foil, actually there is a collision between atoms of the gold foil and alpha particles. Inside the atoms of the gold foil, what is present? Nucleus is present. So there is nucleus is positively charged particle. Even the gold foil atoms ಗಳ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಗೆ ಏನ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ and positively charged, and this alpha b means alpha particles is positively charged. So positive positive nodu enagutte, there exists a force of repulsion. So to indicate the force of repulsion, some are deflected like this and some are deflected in straight line direction. And see, 1 in 8000 alpha particles, 1 in 8000 alpha particles, they retraced their path, they were deflected in backward direction, retraced alpha ray, So 1 in 8000 end samira alpha particles bandide hodu andre adralli ondu kena idu ondena aitu it retraced its original path, because here the angle of scattering is greater than 90 degree. Angle of scattering is almost 180 degree idu ing bandu inga ee tara scattering 180 degree idena adhe line alli untavaru illi yara angle of scattering is less than 90 degree. Here the angle of scattering is 0. Here the angle of scattering is less than 90 degree. So what are the reasons for this type of scattering? Why the angle of scattering is different for different alpha radiations? It was explained based on the force of repulsion. So here gold foil is consisting of many number of atoms, and atom is electrically neutral, but inside the atom there is a nucleus. That nucleus is positively charged, and these alpha radiations means these are also positively charged, and those radiations which are directed towards the nucleus of an atom, they resulted in a force, they experienced a force of repulsion. So which radiation went directly towards the nucleus of the gold foil, that resulted in a backward deflection, because their positive charge and it is also having positive charge. Between positive and positive there exists a force of repulsion. To indicate the force of repulsion, it scattered in backward direction. So here the angle of scattering is almost 180 degree or greater than 90 degree. For this greater than 90 degree and in this same line only it is almost 180 degree. So it is concluded that in an atom, gold foil alli iruvanta atom, of the atom alli positive charge ello ond kade irutte, because almost all the radiations they deflected, they passed through the gold foil without any scattering. Yav kade no scatter aagade baalashtu hogidu ingodu en gotta ingodu enanta just they were not moving directly towards the nucleus of the gold foil. They may have moved some distance away from the nucleus. Those moved away from the nucleus, they resulted in zero deflection, zero scattering. Those moved near to the positive charge, near to the positively charged nucleus, they resulted in some angle of scattering. They scattered with some minimum angle. Which moved directly towards the nucleus of an atom, nucleus of this gold foil, they resulted in backward or retraced, they retraced their original path. So and it is confirmed that in an atom there is a nucleus, and entire charge and the mass of the nucleus, entire charge it is present inside the nucleus, and around the nucleus there is maximum empty space is present. So this is why Rutherford is credited as the discoverer of the nucleus. Yes, so who is the discoverer of nucleus? Nucleus na yaar kandidru andre ide experiment modalu prove madidru. Iga nan yen helagidu gotta namage illi ondu saavira alpha particles nu hogtave illi hogi kovana salpa 90% seed over one. Just 1% nalli idu ee tara scattered adu adu 8000 nalli one enayitu ulta in bandi yak baruttandre aa nucleus ge iga atoms ide hogtavu antu nodu gold foil alli iruvanta atoms gala sidare hogtavu hogi nucleus andre nu middle it is considered as central part of the nucleus सो यावदु एक्साक्टली न्यूक्लियस कडे होगुत्ते द वन विच मूव्स एक्साक्टली टुवर्ड्स द न्यूक्लियस ऑफ एन एटम दैट रिजल्ट्स इन द बैकवर्ड डिफ्लेक्शन एंड वन मूव्स जस्ट अवे फ्रॉम द न्यूक्लियस दैट रिजल्ट्स इन द सम एंगल स्कैटरिंग सो दैट स्कैटर्स विद सम मिनिमम एंगल which results which the rays which moved away from the nucleus they moved straightly without any scattering because there is no force acting on these alpha particles for the scattering so these moved straightly without any scattering so which one resulted in see yaavu nucleus swalpa hatradalli bandu avu ist angle alli scattered aadu yaavu nucleus ki dooradalli hodu avu yaavade scattered adenu ಚದರಿ ಹೋಗೋದು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗೋದು ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬ್ ಆಗೋದು ಅವಳು ಒಂದು ಪಾಪ ಅವಳು ಒಂದು ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬ್ ಆಗೋದು ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬ್ ಆಗಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲೊಂದು ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪಲ್ಷನ್ ಇರಬೇಕು ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪಲ್ಷನ್ ಯಾವುದ್ರ ನಡುವೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಒಂದು ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಆಲ್ಫಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಕೂಡ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಅಂದರೆ ದೇರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪಲ್ಷನ್ ದೇರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪಲ್ಷನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಸೊ ದೇ ಫೋರ್ ರದರ್ಫೋರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ very much successful in see to explain about structure of an atom so in the next class I am telling about observations and final conclusions of this experiment final conclusions what are the final conclusions given by Rutherford and what is the experimental observations of this experimental observations given see experimental observations means what is the size of an atom and what is the size of the nucleus as proved from from this experiment I will explain those in the next class
see let us discuss experimental observations now only let's we shall final conclusions I will tell you on tomorrow so see here what are the I hope you understood about this experiment it's very simple see here A source of alpha particle is placed in the lead cavity. This source produced many number of alpha particles, and those several alpha particles they are passed through the lead bricks. So these lead bricks they arranged several number of alpha particles as a single beam. One sanna vandu ye dappane vandu line aagi idu arrange madu single beam collimated beam. Single beam. So this beam of alpha particles now it is made to focus or it is made to incident fall on the gold foil. So here its thickness is very small. It is having gold colored plates. So it is coated with gold color. So therefore it is called gold foil. And see when it is incident on the gold foil, what happened? Alpha particles they are scattered in different directions they moved in different directions after coming out of the gold foil and they produced scintillations or light flashes on the zinc sulfide screen the screen name is zinc sulfide screen it is able to produce the light you see detect the light flashes in the light ಏನಾದ್ರು ಬಿತ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಕಾಣ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು ಜಿಂಕ್ ಸಲ್ಫೈಡ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ರದರ್ಫೋರ್ಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಎ ಡಿಟೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಮೈಕ್ರೋಸ್ಕೋಪ್ ಟು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ದೀಸ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಫ್ಲಾಶಸ್ ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸಿ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅಲ್ಫಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಪಾಸ್ಡ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಎನಿ ಡಿವಿಯೇಷನ್ ಯಾವುದೇ ಡಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಯಾವುದೇ ಆಂಗಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಕ್ಯಾಟರ್ಡ್ ಆದರೆ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಲ್ಫಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಅಲ್ಫಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಪಾಸ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಫಾಯಿಲ್ without any scattering
Other, it means straight line. Second point here, very few of the alpha particles scattered with the large angles. Bada kadime idu large angle, idu large angle, idu pathinga, so idu large angle, idu vera angle, idu zero angle. The angle of scattering is more here compared to this one, here large angle. So here very few, second point, very few alpha particles scattered, very few alpha particles are scattered with large angle of scattering, with large angle of scattering. And 1 in 8000 alpha particles retraced ulta varudu, retraced its original path. Retraced its original path. 1 in 8000 ಎಂಟು ಸಾವಿರದ ಪ್ರಕರಣದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದೇನಾಯಿತು, ತಂದಾದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಉಲ್ಟಾ ಬಂದ. ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್, ಯಾಕೆ ಬಂದು ಉಲ್ಟಾ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲ್ಲ ನಿಮಗೆ, ಯಾವುದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ಗೆ ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಹೋಯಿತು. ಸಪೋಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಫಾಯಿಲ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್, ಇದು ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಫಾಯಿಲ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್, ಇದು ಆಲ್ಫಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಹಿಂಗ್ ಬಂದು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು, ಹಿಂಗ್ ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಹಿಂಗ್ ಹೋದು. ಸೊ ಹಿಂಗ್ ಬಂತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹಿಂಗ್ ಡಿಫ್ಲೇಷನ್, ಯಾವ್ದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಬಂದು ಅದು ಉಲ್ಟಾ ಬಂದಿದೆ, ರಿಟ್ರೇಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ. ಯಾವ್ದು ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಬಂದು ರಿಟ್ರೇಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಯಾವ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಈ ಕಡೆ ಬಂದದ್ದು ಹಿಂಗ್ ಹೋಯ್ತು. ಸೊ ಈ ತರ ಏನಾಯ್ತಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಕೆಂಡ್ರು, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಷನ್ಸ್ ಹೇಳುವಾಗ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಐಡಿಯಾ ಬರುತ್ತ. ಸೊ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ವಾಟ್ ಸಿ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ಫಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ರೀಚಸ್ ಟು ದ ಜಿಂಕ್ ಸಲ್ಫೈಡ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಅಟ್ ಅನ್ ಆಂಗಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಕ್ಯಾಟರಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು 4th power of sin θ/2. ಇಯರ್ ಹೊಮಿನಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸಂಖ್ಯೆಯ ಅಲ್ಫಾ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಗಳು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಾವ, ಜಿಂಕ್ ಸಲ್ಫೈಡ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಬಂದು ಬೀಳ್ತಾವ, ಅಥವಾ ಆ ಲೈಟ್ ಫ್ಲಾಶಸ್ ನ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾವ ಅನ್ನೋದು. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ವರ್ಸ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಪೋರ್ಷನಲ್ ಟು sin of power 4 θ/2. So the total number of alpha particles which are received by the zinc sulfide screen is inversely proportional to 4th power of sin of θ/2. It is inversely proportional to 4th power of sin of θ/2. So these three are taken as experimental observations of Rutherford's alpha scattering experiment. Yes, what is the first one? Maximum number, about 90% of the alpha particles, they pass in from gold foil without any scattering, without any deflections. So very few alpha particles are scattered with large angle of scattering, that is 1 degree or less than 10 degree, less than 90 degree, either way. And 1 in 8000, very few they are scattered with the large angle of scattering, and it means greater than 90 degree here. And 1 in 8000 they retrace their original path. 1 in 8000 alpha particles, it scattered in a backward direction due to repulsive force from the nucleus of gold foil. And see how many number of alpha particles are, see, they reached the ZNS screen, means here that number is given inversely by sin to the power of 4 θ/2, 1 divided by sin to the power of 4 θ/2. And conclusions I will explain in next class. Have a nice day.